Hello everyone, Kaplan here again with another video. The last one is a while back and we had a lot of changes and of course new card releases like the Dark Angels and the Defenders of Caliban, also the Knights. I think you saw them and I think a lot of people hate them still. Yeah, I'm going to do a couple of videos in the next days and weeks, and I'm starting with Meroya Astellan, which has been in the shop again a few days ago, and yeah, going to show you my deck that I'm currently running and a few gameplays. Yeah, Meroya Astellan is first master of the Defenders of Caliban. Usually, I mean, Defenders of Caliban are basically those Dark Angels that either returned to Caliban together with Lusa after being basically exiled by the Lion, or those that were recruited back then because the Lion gave Lusa the order to heavily recruit and increase the power of the Dark Angel Legion. His ability is really awesome. If you played the latest events, you had a chance to try it, and he did really, really well. Because yeah, you can spawn a Caliban Jäger, which is a 1/1 infantry, and you can spend the same amount of energy of 1 to destroy any troop and deal 3 damage to a random enemy. So basically, it's a mini mortar strike whenever you spend 1 energy and kill a troop. So this offers a lot of synergy with Pride of Caliban, where you can act again if you put and play an infantry, and this is important, infantry, not Astartes, and that is why the Pride of Caliban is much much better used in conjunction with Astellan in comparison to, of course, Cypher anyway, but also the Harrier, because he puts in play an Astartes, and Lusa, which I don't have yet, just gives -3 to attack to an enemy troop. Right. Yeah. Okay, now going over the deck. So Dueling Sight is always a good idea if you have a Warlord ability that you want to use regularly, because at least in those turns where you play it, you can play your ability and still be on curve. Or you can use it to refill to a higher value to use this ability more in conjunction with Pride of Caliban and with Praetor Kassiel, who puts a play on Caliban Jäger, an infantry, whenever a troop dies. So this is an awesome combo which you can pull off, and many people pulled off in the latest events. Because of course in event games it's not as easy to get rid of priority targets like him, because of the lack of removal and so on. And if you got him on and he survives, you can destroy any troop with your ability, deal 3 damage to a random enemy, and Praetor Kassiel will spawn another Caliban Jäger, which will then trigger your Pride of Caliban and give you an act again. So then you can destroy that very same Jäger, kill it for 3 damage, and he spawns again and again and again and again, wins repeat. So in conjunction with Dwelling Sight, you can basically do it 12 times at turn 10 or 14 times, even if you have both, and assuming the cast deal is already in play. So the command bridge is a flex spot, but it's nice to get the Pride of Caliban if you need it or don't have it yet, or to get, for instance, a Covenant of Death or behind enemy lines at turn 10, for instance. Kaizulain, flex spot too. I love him because he churns out legendary tactics. And of course, it's an infantry that I can sacrifice if I want. And it's a priority target that will see a removal card from your enemy, or a gem, for instance. The background is just for stealth aid. If you don't want to use them, or hate them, or don't have them, you can put in an informant network or whatever. It's just always a little bit a good idea to have stealth aid. I have one to Chulcha engine because I want to draw this one at one point in the game usually, and if I already have some, I can of course switch over to this one or to this one depending on what I get. It's basically the same as in Command Bridge, you get a choice of three, and of course with the amount of troops and tactics in the game, it's a low chance. But I'm feeling comfortable with one at this point, because it offers value, but it's not the all answer that I really need to. Megador, of course, why not? Return an enemy troop, then kill it for 3 damage. These guys, because why not? They spawn another Caliban Jäger and a 3-2 body, it's okay. Ramiel, of course, if you have him. This deck does not need him, because in difference to the Hariel, you don't aim to have the big board and then attack. Yeah. You basically just have weenies on the field and you try to kill them and do splash damage. Watchers in the Dark, I think Gem is pretty important at the moment. Getting rid of Survivor, getting rid of warded units, or at least on the ward on the warded units and so on. And as this is not targeted, you can get rid of, for instance, ward on a unit. So I really like them. Of course, they are with 2 damage very, very susceptible to any AoE damage. But if your opponent does not have stealth aid or removal, you can really, really slow him down until he can remove them. Jubak, because why not? Getting another card, and he always puts legendaries in my book, at least when the enemy has him. And yeah, you get a free card. Enemy will either kill it, or you can attack and then ping it for a total of 5 damage on the enemy warlord, of course. Some healing and stun removal, also an infantry, which you can use your ability on. Caliban Knight, because flank plus your sneak attack from your counter attack card, if you go second, is a nice combination. Or just put a player in play another Caliban Jäger, which you can either hope he survives to the next turn or just ping him with your Warlord instantly. As I said, Port of Caliban is an auto-include. These guys are nice also. Flank, 4-3, draw a card on Backlash, nothing not to like here. This is the other single card I have for Card War. Of course, with the troop tactic ratio I won, this is on average 2 Jaggers and 3 cards, which is the exact value that I expect for spending 5 energy. One Covenant of Death to get rid of beefy or priority targets that I cannot get rid of. A really great counter versus Desperate Defense. Atias, because why not? Nothing not to like about him. These guys, of course, 2 times. And Irresistible Charisma is just awesome. On the other Dog Warlords, you should add at least 1 Sabotage. So if you take a unit and you don't manage to kill it by attacking the enemies, you can just jam it and it will stay on your side. With Mary Asselan, you don't need it because you can steal the unit, attack because it got fast, and then kill it immediately if it survives. Awesome. Behind enemy lines, because why not? It's a little bit better on Zahariel, but because you will usually kill your troops anyway, but in case you play the Calibans hard, and assuming those Jaggers survive, you can then use this to finish your enemy off. This is certainly a card you could remove, and I might in the future. Caliban's Heart, as I just showed, I have 1 of them. You can add a 2nd one if you like. And I still got Aldorok in here. I think Aldorok is better off in looser decks. I have to admit, I like the art. I like the effect, also it's not so fitting here. But I have to admit, the amounts of times I got this thing on the field and it survived to the next turn are very, very few incidents. If you can manage to use it, getting, for instance, 1 of those beefy Knight Commanders for 2 energy is nice, but it happens once in a blue moon. So, So, Idyllwick ist a flex board. Grand Army Alliance is a flex board. These guys are not. Basically, the only must have is Port of Caliban, Praetor Castile. Everything else is debatable. Okay. Now let's show some footage. Yeah. I'm always looking up here for the battle log, but they moved it down here. And yeah, let's start with this one. Oops, wrong button, sorry, Lodge. So, I hate Flamemaster. He's so annoying. I don't know who I dislike more, Flamemaster or Curse. But this is one reason I like Estolon, because he can't use his ability on my duplicitous units. And I really don't care what he does, because I play my game and not his. Hey look, Flamemaster, I got two units under the board and you can't use the ability on them and you can't attack them. What are you going to do? Play a tactic, of course. But I still have a unit on the board. So, 3 damage incoming. Getting firstly first word on my troop to play my ability to get a troop. I could have played, of course, Knight or Pride of Caliban here, but I suppose he has some sort of removal or some flank or fast troop, so I wanted to not use a Caliban Knight right away. More board control is better than less. So it's pinging for damage. Now play the Knight and spawn another dude. Now I have energy left and can ping him with 3 damage. Now I'm playing the Pride of Caliban because now I have energy left to do some stuff. Kill that dude. Spawn another one for free and do it again. It's random. I wouldn't have mind if it killed his infantry, but 6 damage on the enemy warlord is not bad either. And now he made a tactical error. He should have killed my troop. So the good part is now I can make use of the Covenant of Death. Just use the knight for it. Could have attacked with the knight, the warlord, and then. Oh no, I couldn't. It was completely right how I did it. Because I need a clear board to spawn another troop. And this is the reason why sacrificing it. I don't really depend on having troops on the board as much as a Hariel, for instance. Because I can always make more. And act again if I have my tactic on the board. They don't care that I can't attack, because why should I attack? So it was not the target that I wanted to hit. So I decided, let's play Caliban's Heart now. Let's see how much removal he still has on his hand. But 5 damage is not bad. So he is in lethal range now and he really has to do something. Of course, Informant Network, always a good include in any deck. My board is gone. But I don't care. could have picked my Kai Solan. I could have killed him that turn. Now I was trying to do the combo, but luck was on my side, so the first sacrifice did the job. Could have pinged him two more times. Yeah, so that was a Flame Master, which of course 30 health. Yeah, he's annoying, but he is not the most ladder worthy warlord. So let's take. Whoops, wrong button. Khan. Yeah. This one was funny, but yeah, he conceded early. Yeah, this one is pretty good game. Yeah, wrong button. Sorry, Lodge. So, yeah, I mean, Vulcan is always a pain in the ass to fight against because he has all those beefy units. He runs well with desperate defense. He can heal up and gain survival all the time later on. He has those annoying weapons that give him splash damage and destroy on hit and whatever. And here he now has a pretty decent advantage because he got the Watchers in the Dark himself, which can counter any other effect that I have on my troops. So I do some bait. He can't spawn another unit because of this guy's in the game. Okay, he jams my Jubak, which is fine for me. And I got a Melgador from him. Let's get another Melgador. Two on the hand is always nice. And now I attacked with Jubak and killed Jubak. But sadly did not kill his troop. Getting some stuff on the board to keep him busy. And this was an error on his part in my book. Because why did he attack that? Now I can play my Watcher, kill his one. Ping that for 3 damage. Pop his survivor. And now he has to do something here, either to wait to get another batch of survivor on that thing, or give survivor by playing something else on it. So return his troop. Gems is for good. Kill Melgator and waits us out. So the Covenant of Death just came in time here. Spawn another unit. Kill that dude. Shoot him because I can. And let's play the Covenant. So satisfying to see his units die. Now the magic is coming. Ah, pure love. I like it. Still overconfident. I have no idea why he played Melgator now. And now it's over for him. Say hi to Master Ramiel. Of course, I could have also played the Praetor Castile combo and with some luck achieved the same, but it's working as it is. Oh, nice challenge. Actually, I got all cards now from the Dark Angels. I still need Loser. Okay, so yeah, that is my my deck right now. I really like it because games are really fun and a lot of ways to play it and a lot of combinations that work really well. As I said, you don't really need all the same cards. You don't need to put all the same cards in. I think Caliban Knight should be in there. Pride of Caliban is a must. Castile is a must. Irresistible Charisma is just an awesome combination with him. And the rest is a flex or as you like. Yeah. Probably still tinkering around, been putting things out and things in, depending on who I face. But so far, I really like it. It's a nice pace of change in comparison of what we have. And yeah, of course, it's also more fun for the opponent in difference to playing versus a knight or playing as a knight. Also, the knights are not as strong anymore. It's still frustrating to play against them, especially if you need board troops on the board. Yeah, because one laser for one damage is gonna kill all your jaggers and then you will have some sort of problem. But yeah, every deck has a weakness, of course, and every warlord has. Alright, then, thank you for your attention. Going to do another video soon. Have a good day, a good night, and yeah, if you have any advice or tips or ideas how to improve the deck or how to build a different deck with him maybe, then please feel free to post it in the comments. And yeah, if you liked it, give this a thumbs up. If you want and you didn't do yet, please subscribe. Not doing too many videos over time, and so you will not get spammed. And yeah, hope to hear from you and see you soon. Bye.